Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And for those of you that are new here, hey, my name is Tenna and I have big fluffy curly hair. And also, welcome to my circus. This is definitely a step up in energy from my last video. My last video I had to film at like 6 o'clock in the morning and I feel like I was just like the entire time. But I'm awake now, it's the weekend, it's Saturday, so I'm filming for you guys. So, guess what I got in the mail today? Got a big black box. Got something that's pretty hyped. A lot of controversy around it. We got us the Life's a Drag palette from Lunar Beauty. Yes, so it's in this box right here. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna go over this palette, we're gonna swatch it, we're gonna play with it, we're gonna do all the things with it. If you want to stick around and watch this, then I suggest you stick around and watch this. Otherwise, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, you should subscribe to my channel because this is the circus and everybody wants to run away and join the circus because the circus is just a great place to be, whatever you want to be. Yeah. All right, let's hop into the video. All right, so I almost didn't get this palette today. I was actually kind of laughing because it showed, the shipping showed that it was supposed to deliver today, but something got held up and then it was like stuck at my local post office and then said that it couldn't deliver until Monday. And I was like, no, girl, no, messing with my filming schedule. So I had to drive to the post office and go pick this up. But we're here, we've got it. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull this bad boy out. There's been a lot of controversy around this palette. You know, with the whole Jeffrey Manny drama, whatever, him using Jeffrey for whatever to make his palette and all that whatever stuff. And then just like drama in general around the palette and, you know, people wanting to support it, people not wanting to support it. I've always liked Manny, he makes me laugh, things like that. So I definitely wanted to get my hands on this palette because I thought it looked really cool. So anyway, when you get it, this is what it looks like. It is in this nice chrome package and it has a Life's a Drag on it in this nice gold lettering here. Yes. So if we go ahead and open this bad boy up, this is what it looks like and the packaging is beautiful. And honestly, this palette is way bigger than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was gonna be like this, like my cute little Mickey Mouse palette. Like I thought it was gonna be like that size. And you guys, this palette is like massive. Like next to my head, it's a pretty big palette. It's a big palette. Anyway, I love what he did here on the packaging. I love this like rainbow duochrome effect to it. I thought that was really cool. And then according to him, these are his eyes in drag on the front. And then it says Life's a Drag in this nice like pinky chrome kind of color. And then on the back, it has the Lunar Beauty logo as well as the Life's a Drag name on it as well. Yeah, this thing is pretty like sturdy, you guys. Like this is not a light palette by any means. I feel like a lot of like these kind of palettes can be really light and flimsy. Like this feels very like light and cardboardy. Of course, this was $8, so I don't really expect like that much out of it. But this has got some like, this is like a book. It's got some like heaviness to it. So I'll stop talking about it. Let's go ahead and open her up. This is what it looks like on the inside. Ooh. So this is what it looks like. See if we can go ahead and peel this nice little protective cover off of it. Yes. You guys, these look really pretty, like just like in person. Like I've seen it like all over like Instagram and like all that stuff. And it just looks so much prettier in person, I think. Yeah, so we've got us some colors. So it looks like in here we've got 14 shades. It looks like 12 mattes and 2 shimmers, which makes me happy. I am so tired of these companies making palettes with like all shimmers. I can't do anything with a whole palette of shimmers, so I do more things with mattes. And then we've got like 2 really nice shimmer shades. And then also I love the detail here at the top. It says be a queen right here in the mirror. Sorry if it's blinding you. And then I don't know if you can kind of see like in the mirror, but it does have this really cool like rainbow pearl effect around the outside of the mirror. And I thought it's a really cute touch as well. You know, everybody was giving him shit about it because it's a Life's a Drag palette and he's not a drag queen and whatever. You know, it's his first palette, leave Manny alone. Plus he even like explained that like the drag community is the reason why he got into makeup anyway. So like it is what it is. As long as the colors are good, like why does it matter? And also inside of it, it comes with this little brush. Not really expecting to be that impressed with the little brush in here. It looks like it's a little duo, little synthetic brush, which it feels kind of nice. We can go ahead and play with it and see how it feels, but more or less I'll be pulling in my favorite brushes. But it does feel like a nice brush, and it does have Lunar Beauty in the center of it in pink, if we can zoom in on that, if my lights will cooperate. Probably not. But anyway, we'll go through, we're gonna swatch all of these colors, and then we're gonna create an eye look. So let me go ahead and get up, swatch these colors for you guys, see how they look, see how they feel, things like that, just because I don't trust anybody on the internet. I feel like the only people I've seen play with this palette so far are Manny and like other beauty influencers that have gotten his palette ahead of time. So like, I don't know if I necessarily always like trust like what people have to say, because I feel like if like your best friend puts a palette out, like you're gonna hype it up, right? Like you're like, I'm sure you'd tell her like the truth behind closed doors, but like not in a review, if that makes sense. So I feel like it's been really hyped up by like other beauty gurus. I haven't really seen like your normal everyday person look at it yet. So we're gonna see if these are patchy, if they're powdery, if they're chalky, if they're whatever. So we'll go ahead and jump on into these swatches. But I'm gonna go ahead and go into this first one right here. It is in the color Cake Face. It is a nice white, a nice matte white. It is very, very, very buttery in the pan. Let's see if we can get this to zoom, because when I did the Mickey Mouse one, I didn't realize that these were all really blurry, so I'm sorry if it's blurry. But here's the white one right there, which seems to be pretty pigmented. I'm gonna go into the next one right here. It's in the color Sickening, which is this nice little transition-y nude color. There is like glitter in that. Maybe there's glitter on my hand, sorry. So there's that nude one. The next one up is the color Hunty, which is this nice little mauve-y brown color. The next one is the color Beat, which is the first shimmer that I'm gonna swatch in this entire palette. I'm gonna go ahead and go in there with my finger. Ooh, honey, she's pigmented. She is shimmery. Next, I'm gonna actually skip down to the other colors and then I'll swatch the colors separately over here. I'm gonna go into the color Shady down here. Y'all know how I feel about the color Black as far as eyeshadow pigments go. I'm gonna be real judgy on this one, especially after that Mickey Mouse review that I did. This one doesn't feel as soft, but we'll see. Oh, honey, she's black. Woo! Okay, Manny. I see you. Next one in this palette is in the color Trade, which is this nice deep color, this deep kind of brown. It's kind of like a, let's go ahead and swatch that here. These are swatching like amazingly so far. You guys are extremely pigmented. They're really, really buttery. Here's the color Mug right here. Sorry if you couldn't see those first few swatches. I'm, you know, kind of the same color as those swatches. And then we'll go into the color Legendary, which is this gold here with my pinky. Oh my gosh. Dude, these shimmers are like to die for. All right, let's go ahead and swatch these beautiful colors. We're going to go into the yellow shade right here, which is in the color Campy, which is this bright yellow. I'm a little bit judgy on yellows too, because sometimes they're not very pigmented. So let's go in here with our finger. Yeah, don't really see it. So it's not as pigmented as I thought it would be. Let's go into this next one, Pageant Queen, which is this purple. Let's go ahead and swatch next to that. Pageant Queen is pigmented. Next one is in the color Kai Kai. Let's go ahead and go in here with this Fanga. I know he said that this was going to be more of a transition shade, so it wasn't going to be like as poppy as the other colors, but the yellow isn't really all that poppin' either, so the swatch is okay. Oh, sorry, it's not Kai Kai, it's Kiki. Sorry, this is Kai Kai. I was reading the pink when I was swatching the blue, so let's go ahead and go in with Kai Kai right here in this pink. Swatch it there, which that one's pretty pigmented as well. It's not, definitely not as pigmented as the purple. We'll go into the color Snatched, which this one is like screaming to me. I love the red.
and swatch there. Yes. Ooh. And then the last one is in the color Fishy, which this actually looks to be more of like a shimmery color as well, which is this nice blue color. Let's go ahead and swatch that one here. Yes. That one is extremely pigmented. So those are all of the colors, you guys. I do apologize if this is blurry. I can't really tell from my angle that I'm standing at. But those are all the shades. So far, they swatch really, really well. The only ones that are kind of like questionable is this yellow and this kind of like blue color. They didn't swatch as well as the other ones. But everything else looks amazing. So I'm gonna go ahead and wipe these off and we will go ahead and dive into an eye look.
All right, so we got those all nice and swatched for you guys. So far, it does look promising. However, those of you that are not new here, you do know that I am not a fan of finger swatches. I like to see how things work on the eyes. So now we're gonna go into my favorite test. Doing an eye look, I'm gonna go ahead and zoom in on my face so you guys can kind of follow along, see what I'm doing. We'll test to make sure there isn't a lot of fallout, all that good stuff. So let me zoom the camera in and we will start the eye look. All right, so we're all zoomed in on my face. Let's go ahead and prep the lid. I'm gonna go in with the MAC paint pot in the color Painterly, which is this guy right here. For those of you with fair skin tones, they also have it in the color Soft Ochre, which is a little bit lighter. This one just works for deeper skin tones. So I'm gonna go ahead and go in with this, and I'm gonna go in and apply it with a finger because that is my favorite way to apply it. All right, we've got them all nice and prepped and primed. As you can see that my lids look a lot lighter now. I'm gonna kind of do just more of like a nude type of eye with just a little bit of a pop of color. I don't wanna get too crazy because I am going wine tasting as soon as I'm done filming this and I don't wanna go outside in like full drag. I don't even know how to do drag makeup, but you know, I don't wanna have like really crazy bright colors leaving the house. So, anyway, let's go ahead and pop on into this. I am going to go into the color Sickening right here, which is this nice kind of a tan color. I'm gonna take a nice, humongous, fluffy blending brush to smoke this out into the crease. No, I did not set what I put on my eyes. So I'm gonna go in with the Morphe M535 brush. I'm gonna go ahead and dip into there. A smidgen, there's like not really any fallout, which is like cool. There's like, you know, a little bit of dusting, but nothing too crazy. Go ahead and pop this into the crease and just kind of warm up that crease area. Are these blend out really, really nicely? Definitely like not gonna judge it off of one transition shade. I feel like the transition shades are always the easiest to blend out no matter what palette you have, but so far this is blending out really nice. No patchiness. Next, I'm gonna go into the color Mug right here. I'm also gonna take that and blend that into my crease. I'm actually gonna go in with a Morphe M576 blending brush. So I'm gonna go ahead and dip on into Mug. I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of pop that into the crease. We're going into a little bit of a darker brown. I skipped the color Hunty and just went straight for Mug. So far, you guys, this is actually blending out really, really nicely. No patchiness, nothing crazy. I'm gonna go ahead and take that big fluffy blending brush and just kind of diffuse the edges here. All right, next I wanna take an even smaller blending brush and I actually wanna pop into the color Snatch right here, this red, and I actually wanna take some of that and mix it in with that brown that I just popped into the crease. So kind of make it more of like a red smoke effect going on in here. Alright, next I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna do a half cut crease. So I'm gonna go in and just cut off, not cut off, but you know, block out this inner corner on both sides. And I'm gonna be going in with my MAC paint pot again for this. And you guys, this is a positive channel. I do know that I'm probably using products that don't mix. Just like you see, I am using a Jeffree Star mirror while using Manny's palette. Don't care. Alright, our crease is cut. I'm gonna go ahead and go in with a nice little packing brush. I'm gonna go in with this guy right here from the Vintage Company. I got this in one of my boxy charms and I cannot get this purpley blue black stain out of it, but I'm actually going to go into the color Beet, which is this nice shimmery color up here. I'm gonna try and apply it with a brush first, and then if that doesn't work, then I'll try it with a finger, but I wanna go ahead and just press it on with a brush first just to see how it goes. Wow, this is really pretty, you guys. I'm actually gonna go in with my finger and just pack it on just a little bit, just with my finger, just to kind of add a little bit more. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and go into the color Trade right here, which is kind of like a reddish brown. I'm gonna take that on a tiny fluffy blending brush, like the same one that we used for Snatched. I'm gonna go in and dip into that, and I'm gonna go ahead and pop that into my outer corner. So far, you guys, I'm really impressed with this palette. It's really good. Dude, these blend so well. And then I'm actually going to pop into the color Shady here on the end, just a little dip of it. And I'm gonna pop that into the very outer corner just to deepen this eye look up. Guys, that was only like a little bit of black, and it's like, wow. That is a good black, and it blends really well, and it doesn't make anything muddy. You guys, this palette is like low-key sickening. Like, not even low-key, it is high-key sickening. Like, this is, ooh, I'm really loving these colors and like how everything blends out, and it's like really pretty. Ugh. It's so pretty. I really want to use that purple, but I feel like it's gonna ruin the eye look if I do. Maybe I'll just run like a little bit of purple under my eyes just so like, you know, we can see it in action. So I'm actually gonna go in to the color Pageant Queen, which is this nice purple color. I'm gonna just drag that along the lower lash line along the bottom here. Very purple, very pigmented. So it didn't go on as like of a clown crazy purple as I thought. It's actually really pretty. Wow, so these shadows, you guys, are just like amazing. Like, I'm really impressed with this palette. Like, honestly, I just feel like people were hella hating on it because it was like Manny and stuff, but like, these colors are pigmented AF. They blend to filth. They're just so pretty. Like, this shimmer that's on my eyes right now, you guys, is just like gorgeous. I am super impressed with this. Let me go ahead and throw on some liner and some lashes, and then I will be right back and we'll wrap this up. I'm gonna go ahead and just do a just winged eyeliner type deal, like I always do. Holy shit, you guys. Like, I am like so fucking impressed with this palette. I'm impressed with this look. I feel like I can do like legit makeup. Like, this came out so freaking pretty. Like, this might be my everyday go-to for like, just because it's so perfect for every day. You've got all of your nudes over here, and then you have your colors, which I love the way that he separated these out. I feel like a lot of these palettes, like if he would have did like every other one, it would have looked like really crazy and like clustered, and people kind of like freak out at that, you know, thinking, I don't know what I'm gonna do with all those colors. But I love how it's separated, so you can really like focus on like what you can do with your everyday eye looks, and then you can put in a pop of color if you're feeling a little frisky. I'm in love. I am in love with this palette. Yeah, you guys, this is amazing. His palette is $45, so it's kind of right up there with like everybody else, like ABH, things like that. I will say though, like, I feel like it's right up there with all of those formulas. These blend amazingly. They're pigmented. It's just a beautiful palette. He does still have them in stock. He's not playing the sold out game that everybody else plays to hype up their, you know, products and things like that. So they are still in stock. If you do want to pick it up, you go to his website, lunarbeauty.com, you can pick it up. And shipping with inside of the United States is not very expensive. I do think that it is kind of expensive if you are outside of the United States. So I'm very sorry for those of you that are out of the country. I think it's like 20 bucks, something crazy. Ooh. But anyways, you guys, this gets a huge 2 thumbs up for me. This, like, it's amazing. I think it's a great palette. And I honestly don't understand why people are hating on it. I feel like people are just like hating on it to hate on it because of the whole like Jeffrey Manny Laura situation. And because, you know, he's another beauty guru that's coming out with makeup. But like, he killed it. The formulas are amazing. I mean, these blended to filth. Like, I have never been more proud of an eye look than right now. Like, this is probably some of the best makeup I feel like I've done on myself. I am tooting my own horn. Why? Because I feel like this like palette helped me do that because everything blended so freaking well. So you guys, that is it. This, we're just done. We're just gonna end it here. I'm gonna go, I'm just gonna go because this is great. Otherwise, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.